Hello, my friends. This is Wolfgang with Tools for Ascension. And my gift to you today is this video on the inner marriage of your divine male and female aspects. First, I will talk about these archetypes. And then in the guided meditations, we will perform the inner marriage on an energetic level. So we all, when we talk about male-female polarity, in the physical world, this is represented by estrogen on the female part and testosterone on the male aspect. And without those, we have a rather neutral human. And, everybody has, of course, a mix of those hormones. And accordingly, your secondary sexual attributes, will change. And so every expression, so there, is something there. So you have, a female where they're on one extreme, where there's a lot of, estrogen there and very little testosterone. And then you have, on the other hand, females with very little estrogen and lots of testosterone. And the same with men. You have very masculine men and very feminine men. You have masculine women and very, female, whatever those attributes are. Right? And this is, in a great part, affected by those hormones. And of course, there's also culture as such, but hormones play a huge role on our thinking and our emotions. So we know the sexual dualities, and of course, these also translate into the yin yang philosophy. How to live in duality, basically. Every extreme kind of gets taken over by the other extreme, and there is generally an interplay. Of course, this principle is not only applicable to male-female, but also to our foods. Like there are yin foods, according to, that's this Japanese teaching, probably the Chinese do so too. Yin foods would be like things that are sweet, honey, fruits, and yang foods would be foods that grow under the earth, that are concentrated and salty, like grains and roots. And so yin foods like sugar and, sugary sweet things, even drugs, are considered, yin. Makes you spaced out. Your mind goes all over the place, and yang foods are considered that they focus you, they concentrate you. So you focus on one thing, at the exclusions of other things. And, with this in mind, we come to the left and right brain half. And, this is a whole thing. That the brain halves, you have the male side actually on the left side, because the brain is cross-referenced, in the physical body, the right side represents your male, your masculine aspect, and the left side, of course, the female aspect, but the brain is cross-wired. And so your logical brain is actually on the left side, and your rational, intuitive brain, and your holistic, feminine brain, intuitive brain, is on the right side. And so there seems to be a specialization, and of course, even from the brain efficiency, point of view, it is best when both sides communicate with each other through the corpus callosum, the bridge between the left and right side brain. And I, in my third eye clearing meditation, I work with this a lot. So this is quite important that the two aspects, you know, specialized aspects, you know, talk to each other to get a better picture about what we consider reality. And so also, you know, in those dualities, these also translate to your eyes. You know, the right eye is considered the strong eye and the left eye is considered the weak eye. So if you project chi out of your eye, you can get easier into the left eye. And and there is another duality with eyes, actually, where when the eye is kind of contracted, like a wolf's eye, like a slit eye, you know, you focus on a detail. And when the eye is kind of wide, like a lotus eye, you know, the ideal of female beauty, you know, you have an all-over perception of a scene, like where you look at, well, there is a wall and there is a man walking in front of it, and there seems to be a stride there, and he seems to be in disharmony with the environment. So, you know, it's a synoptic picture of the whole, whereas, you know, a male kind of point of view with the slit eye would, you know, you watch your hands, is he carrying anything in his hands, up his sleeves, you know, are there weapons there, you look for bulges, you know, very detailed observation of that, of a predator, you know, whereas the female observation with the right eye is the observation of a prey, where you, you know, you judge the whole over situation and how it relates maybe to the individual. You know, these are all ways of duality, and, you know, the magician or yogi, you know, he keeps one eye lotus and the other one as a predator. So you have your feet or your eyes in both worlds. another thing about the male and female aspect of us, you know, are those energy flows that go around the spine, this kind of chi flows, they're pretty free-flowing. That's why, you know, many people prefer the Sufi grind as such, so you can, you know, adjust to those flows. And these are the two snakes, you know, the Ida and Pingala, of the Kundalini, you know, those energies that can flow around your spine. And so one of them is always symbolized as red and hot, and the other one is as cooling. And they are also connected with your nostrils. So when you want to heat up, you know, you close your left nostril and breathe, you know, through the right nostril only. This will activate the heating coil, so to say. And, you know, when you want to cool down, you just close your right nostril, and it works quite well, you know, even with ladies on menopause. you know, this was quite successful to their astonishment. Again, you know, a duality, you know, between our sides of the body. And so then this kind of duality is also, you know, represented not just only in the hormones, but what we consider our male and female aspect. And I call the male-female high self, the archetypes. Of course, our soul ultimately on the higher levels is androgynous, because you know, male-female separation is a biological issue, and then maybe a later on a issue of bias in certain directions. Yet, you know, we have a male aspect in us, and everybody has a female aspect in us. And so they have their own personalities. You know, for some people, they appear, you know, quite humanoid. And for some people, they appear very angelic in their form. You know, some just with flowy beauty, some with crowns, some with crowns and outfits like Hindu style. Some see God forms, you know, they are expansion of those forms. And some just see lights, you know, a light, a radiant light, a presence like this, you know, which is not corporal. This and then very much the, at least androgynous, higher dimensional aspects. And but, you know, for beginners, we of course have to work out our own male-female balance, whatever is right for us. So we want to connect, you know, with and balance those aspects and understand them. And so let us talk about, you know, high self. Of course, we all know our archetypes. You know, where you have archetypes, for instance, are described in the tarot cards, where you have specific categories, you know, that humanity falls into, like the warrior maybe, or the parent, like the father, the mother archetype. You know, typical behavior patterns, you know, that are either ingrained in the DNA or into a culture. Like a magician, like a witch, you know, all the different cultures have slightly, you know, the witch may be a shaman in another culture or a priest in another culture, but in principle, you know, there's a certain occupation that humans can specialize on. So the humanoid high self aspects that we have with these different personalities, they may not always get along with each other. So I've seen in my work with people where, for instance, the female high self was very, very mad, very, very angry at the male high self. The male high self, I have to say, was quite a jerk. And not just that, the female high self also complained about the fantasies that the male high self was like entertaining, you know, while, you know, pleasuring himself. And so actually in when I had an interview with both of them and tried to harmonize, you know, the female high self said, you know the black eye that you have on the right side? She says, yeah, this was me, you know, just to stick it to you. So this is how far this this enmity between the high self can go. Another funny story is when one client, where the female high self was a kind of a Diana aspect, and which was very much in defense of animals, right? Which this female high self was, I mean, very, very angry that animals were treated like this, you know, hunted or, you know, farmed in concentration camps. And you know, so militant that I was wondering if I would, you know, maybe, you know, contact the authorities. And so when I called on the male high self, I mean, he was kind of the opposite. And fortunately, you know, we worked it out. But so not necessary that the female high self, you know, has all the, let's say, so-called typical archetypes. You know, there are very warrior-like female aspects, archetypes there. And there are very, can be very warm and gentle male aspect high self there. So all this is possible. And the idea is just that, you know, you bring them together so their work is a, you know, a harmony, a synergy, where they're all work together, you know, and they're together more than they were just the sum of each other. So, and of course, you know, when you look at those high selves, you know, these are projections of your own subconscious, just communications in a way that you have an avatar, like for an AI. You know, it is symbolic, and your imagination is used as a display screen. So sometimes people say, oh, I'm just making this up, what I'm seeing. Yeah, Well, you know, of course you're making it up, you know. I mean, actually you're making up, you know, the whole world around you. It is just an interpretation of the perception you got from your five senses, right? I mean, this is just a construct. It's not what you're seeing in your mind's eye around you. It's just an oversimplification of what is actually there, because you do not see all those frequency. And this is an old thought, you know, about Maya or the matrix from India and the transcendentalists and, you know, Schopenhauer, Hegel, you know, they're all, Kant, Immanuel Kant explored, you know, these ideas. Old head. So before, you know, we get into this guided meditation about male and female merging, you know, you should know some principles that really work, right? You can do a thing right and you can do a thing wrong, or, you know, maybe more efficient or less efficient. So first of all, sit in a comfortable office chair, you know, and either, you know, balance your body so that everything stacks up nicely, and, you know, that you don't have to use any muscles to keep yourself straight. You know, it's going to be quite difficult to go into deep meditation when your back hurts. There's another way where you can do like a Sufi grind, and for those with a nice strong back that's balanced, you know, that's preferable, because once your Kundalini starts running, you can adjust and crank your neck better. And I advise to use earbuds or nice headphones, first of all, to screen out background noise, and also, you know, to have a better sound quality. And, you know, if you're podcasting this or, you know, operating, you know, and driving or operating heavy machinery, don't, you know, please don't. You're going to be so spaced out, you know, it's going to be very dangerous. So, you know, just do something else, listen to music or do some chakra breathing, but, you know, do not do this while driving or operating heavy machinery. But smile like an idiot and reside in your heart. You know, the smiling will open you up to the positive vibration and, you know, therefore help you access, you know, higher dimensions. And so also, you know, you want to breathe very deeply, so you have an energized brain and chakra and energy system, you know. So you want to breathe at a pace that you can hear the air flowing through your nostrils. So, you know, the more you breathe initially, you know, the less, once you're cruising, once your chakras are open, your energy system is running, you know, you're going to have a much, much better experience. And also, you do not have to repeat my affirmations, just think, so be it. Some people have proclaimed a complaint about Amen, that I would refer to Amen Ra. Well, I refer more to the Jewish interpretation, you know, which, you know, that give just permission as such, you know. But you can, if you don't like Amen, that maybe I might sometimes say, you just say yes or nod your head. It doesn't matter. It just means that you agree. It's the intent that counts, you know. And also be in a childlike state of innocence during the guided meditation. Reside in your heart, not in your head. But pay attention to what pops into your mind and do not judge or try to rationalize it. You know, it's like, oh, I just made this up. You can always rationalize it at the end of the meditation. You know, it's like if you watch a movie and you know, you start analyzing how they did the lighting and the CG effects, you know, as I do many times because I was in the video business. you know, you're not going to get the illusions of the effect, you know, of the entrancement that well, you know. So just to be innocent, you know, and just see what pops into your mind. And you can use the K button on your keyboard to play and pause the guided meditation to spend some time, you know, tuning into certain aspects, explore situations, you know, in greater detail. And so in that route, in that vein, some of you may just really benefit if you keep your eyes open after the induction and use your pendulum to investigate further. And I have a video on the pendulum in case you don't know how to use one. So let's close your eyes and we connect now to absolute source. Nobody, nothing beyond this absolute source of everything. And our highest self, our highest consciousness, and our spirit guides that are all the way up to source, all the way up to source. And as a more local representation of source, we connect to Milky Way galaxy and the sun. And of course, we connect to the organic Milky Way galaxy, to the organic sun, to the organic earth, not the digital and artificial overlays. And we connect to the elements here and the seven directions, so to say, the directions north, south, east, west, up, down, and the view inside. And all the beings that still love us unconditionally. Thank you for coming. Amen. And so it is, and so it is, and so it is. And to ask that everything that happens in and from the session is going to be for the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. And so it is. And to also ask that we have maximum benefit and that any resistance in us to experiencing, you know, maximum benefit are cleared till finish. And any resistances towards clearing, those resistances are also cleared to finish. Again, for our highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. And we ask that we are completely safe, that we are free of any deceptions, and that we have a great time, absolute great time. And, you know, that we only assimilate what is beneficial for us and discard what is not applicable to us. And now, just smile like an idiot and imagine that you shapeshift your legs and your spine deep into the earth. And send your roots even deeper and sprout them out into finer and finer side roots. And smile, smile, smile as you approach this benevolent mother of yours. And now on the inhale you allow her love to rise into your system, into your spine, into your legs, into your heart, through those roots. Those roots are just like straws. And lovingly this her energy flows into you and you start responding by smilingly and loving. You send your energy into her and you exhale all the way out, all the way out, till no more air comes out of your lungs. And then you again pull her love into you. All the way with a diaphragm, you expand your chest cage and you even lift your ribs up, your shoulders, till no more air goes in. Then smilingly you send your love again through those roots into the earth and you just go back and forth, back and forth. And we ask the angels and higher beings and our spirit guides and our high self to please clear any blocks that we still carry in our grounding system, you know, in our root chakra, in our legs, in our foot chakras and below in our grounding chakras. Please find all, remove and clear all as many blocks there as possible now. Amen. And just keep breathing through those legs, through your feet, until it tingles, and it tingles, it's good. This means there's more chi flowing. Right. And now start pulling up that love on the inhale into your heart, and on the exhale you send it into your brain. And just keep pushing that love from Mother Earth into your brain to activate it. You know, deep breath, you want to activate as much as possible, supercharge your processor, overclock your brain. Your gamers know what I'm talking about. You got to breathe for that and smile, all right? Overclock it. And we ask that your highest self and your spirit guides remove any predatory cords from the gods, from the Anunnaki, from the reptilians and other ETs and magicians and all lovers from you as much as possible now. Amen. And then also all the negative stuff we picked up from other people and mass consciousness, you know, everybody's kind of whacked out nowadays in anxiety, fearful about the future. So, you know, there's no reason to keep their fear with you. Just let go of that. Ask your high self to clear it. Amen. And then also all the backstabbing energy and the jealousy from other people, their anger, that's even from traffic, as well as your spouse and other people, you know, in your office. That's no reason to keep their mud swinging, you know, with you. Yeah. Alright. And now, start pushing, you know, the earth love, like about up to 6 feet, you know, no, not six, yeah, 6 feet, yeah, 6 feet above your head. If you reach that, you know, you're pretty much out there. And again, we ask the angels and other protectors to make sure you're not going to get hijacked, that you're completely safe, completely safe. Yes, and guided. And we ask for cleansing of your crown chakras from any sabotage, any blocks, any black magic or cords that steals your energy now. Amen. And we ask for an outpouring of love from the higher dimensions, from those that love you unconditionally, your support team, to be poured into you. And just, you know, pull that love into your brain and over your brain tongue into your heart. On the inhale and on the exhale, you send it out to your friends again, you know, through your chakra modem all the way up to 6 feet above the head. That should be pretty good. All right. And now just take that love that's freely offered to you into your heart from the heavens and expand your heart. Pump your heart with it. Yes. And also now add the love from Mother Earth at the same time. So heaven and earth into the heart on the inhale and on the exhale, you just expand your heart. Let it glow like a sun, like a golden sun. But if it's pink or greenish, you know, that's fine too, or white, blazing, you know, it's all good. And we ask that any blocks in your heart and pain that you're still carrying, unnecessary, there from all those lifetimes, be removed as much as possible right now. Just smile like an idiot and please, 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 divine beings, remove as much as possible pain from my heart. Amen, 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 amen. So be it, so be it, so be it. And now we asked for the presence of our female high self to be in front of you. Amen. And most of you probably start feeling like a presence in front of them, like a radiance, maybe some love and light. And some people may even see like a goddess-like or beautiful female appearance, maybe just a little rough outlines, you know, and some of you may just see just a radiance, just light. This is then always a very higher dimensional aspect. And now, on the inhale, you know, draw that love from the female chakra, you know, where this would be. Even if it would be just a blob of light and oval, you know, just where the heart chakra area would be, just draw that love into your heart, and on the exhale, send your love to this part of you, and go back and forth, just like you did with the Earth Mother or with the Heaven Beings. Back and forth. Very good. And now you probably start feeling in your heart, you know, how your heart opens, how it becomes warmer there. More light there, yes. And let's also clear all those vows where we vowed not to love anymore. That was definitely some foolish stuff. Love is the drug. Love makes everything, you know, happy. So, ultimately. So we ask that we will be open to love again. And ask that those foolish vows be cleared now. Amen, 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 amen. And whenever we maybe cursed, you know, women or female aspect, the goddess aspect, we ask for forgiveness and take those curses back now. Amen. And we also ask that any divide and conquer programs between male and female high self be cleared too. Amen. And now we ask the female high self to stand to the left of us. You know, kind of where her heart chakra is, kind of where our physical arm is. You know, the upper arm is. Kind of like that. And now we ask the male high self to be in front of us. Amen. And we, on the inhale, we draw his love into our heart. And on the exhale, we send our love to his heart. Now, amen. Just back and forth. And again, we clear any rejection of the male archetype as much as possible, so that we become very receptive to the divine aspects of the divine male archetype from now on. Amen, 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 for the highest good, so be it. And now you probably feel how your heart chakras open more and more and more and more. Nice. So now have your male high self stand to the right of you. And of course he's taller than you. And so again, his heart chakra probably would be like where your shoulder is, maybe a little higher, right? So both male and female high self are kind of standing half in your body. One is smaller than you, one is taller than you, if you are male. And now, we asked the male high self to just pull the love from the source, from heaven and earth and source into himself. And on the exhale, just send it, you know, into your heart and over your heart to the heart of the female high self. And then on the next breath cycle, you ask the female high self to take the love from heaven and earth and send it on the exhale over your heart to the heart of the male high self. And then you just go back and forth, and you in the middle, you just smile like an idiot, and you do the breathing, and they do the loving and pumping. All right, so start now. Back and forth. And while you're breathing deep and relaxed, smiling like an idiot, we ask that our highest spirit guides, you know, clear all those negative spells and curses and any negative programming, you know, whether it's on the mental plane or on the emotional plane or on the DNA plane or on the cultural plane. You know, that separates, you know, the genders. You know, that instead of creating synergy and harmony and enthusiasm, it just creates strife and anger and inequality. Yes. Please do so now. Amen, 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 amen. And you just keep running love between your male and female high self. You're just in the middle, just doing the breathing, smiling like an idiot. And you're probably feeling, as the clearing happens, that there's a wider a range of love vibration exchange between the male and female aspect, right? And now we asked our higher self to please clear our archetypes as much as possible of any trauma that they have experienced without having to look at the details. No, they all experience, let's say, gender-specific trauma. Like a female got raped and had childbirth problems and separation from loved ones, and they were the weak ones, and males were wasted in wars and tortured in wars and tortured through back-breaking labor and dangerous hunts. You know, everybody, you know, had disadvantages and a lot of trauma as such, and so you like to have this much cleared from them as possible now. Amen. And you have them run love on each other back and forth. Now just go straight. So let's say on the inhale, the female draws the love from the male side, high self side, over your heart into her heart. And on the exhale, she sends her love over your heart to his heart. And so they're going back and forth, running love from the heart chakra back and forth. And just make sure you breathe deeply and keep smiling like an idiot. Right. And now, while maintaining this back and forth on the heart level, also ask them to add the whole neck and throat area to this. So there is now a big vat of chi, of loving chi, traveling from one side, you know, from the neck and heart area to the other side, neck and heart area, you know, from male high self to female high self, back and forth, and you just right smack in the middle here. And now you add the whole brain area, also the facial area, you know. Send love over the eyes, over the cheeks, over the third eye, which is the brain area. Just, you know, exchange those energies. Their different qualities, and to each appreciate, you know, the energies of the other gender. Because it creates a balance. So basically you exchange in a big chunk of loving chi, you know, going from the heart all the way up to the head. And now you add, let's say, 30 centimeters or 1 foot of above the head crown chakra, like the lower crown chakras. Yep, that's very spacey, very satisfying to me at least. And now go even higher, you know, go up to 3 foot high, this would be about a meter, back and forth. So now you go basically from the heart up to a meter above the head, back and forth, exchange. That's getting more spacey, right? And now even go another 1 or 2 foot higher. Try see how high you can go. Maybe 2 meters. I keep it at that. There's a reason why you shouldn't be driving a car or operating heavy machinery. I wouldn't do my taxes now either, so. All right. And now you add the solar plexus chakra, you know, which is, you know, just the area below your ribcage. Just add that, you know, with the whole heart chakra all the way up to the crown chakra, this back and forth. Back and forth with the breath, smile like an idiot, make sure your higher self smile like an idiot. Yeah. All right. And now you add the sacral chakra. Now it's gonna be a little bit more juicy. Deep breathing in and out. Smile like an idiot, and also do not do this on a park bench or where other people can see you. You know, you might be searched for heroin or other enhancements. yeah, and now, this is going to be a kicker, at the root chakra. Make it nice, red and hot. Like one of those rockets that launches at NASA, like, yes, back and forth, smile like an idiot, deep breathing, yeah, this is going to be very, very energizing. And now also, you know, add, you know, all the legs, so up to the feet, to this whole thing. Yeah, this is now as if like there is a ghost of love is traveling between the male and female higher self, back and forth with the breath. Deep breathing, deep smiling. I can't breathe here, I have to talk all the time, so. And now we asked that they even, you know, exchange love and energy below your feet, you know, so it's just like a tree, you have a root chakra system going deep into the earth, to just, you know, like you have a, like a tree, you have a branch system above your head. So just exchange this energy too. This is probably a quite a new sensation for many of you. Oh, and spacey, oh yeah. And if it freaks you out, just, you know, and you get all spacey or just compact this energy in your spine. Just draw it onto the inhale into your spine. And with this compacting into your spine, actually draw your male and female higher self more and more, you know, into your body, so that gradually they start merging in your spine, that their spines merge with your spine. But take your time, take your time, enjoy this, right? So every time you inhale, you know, you pull them closer together. And every time you exhale, you know, you take this energy from the spine and shoot it up the top of the head. And smile like an idiot. And notice how the energy that you're actually shooting up kind of starts raining down back at you, and it's also getting recycled. And now, you know, we ask them to completely merge in your body together, so that your male high self and your female high self and you, the present local here on this earth, are just superimposed on each other. And that's definitely a cool feeling, you know, you're taller in your shoulders and hopefully way more radiant than before. And to ask them, you know, to promise you to keep working together now in synergy and to love each other. Amen. Have them agree. And we also asked that our androgynous high self, you know, that's way above them on the higher dimension, that outranks them, that is more wise and detached and closer to source, that it can counsel them, so they have a counselor, a handler, a go-to, to access the wisdom, you know, of the stuff they cannot access from now on. Amen, 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 amen. And again, we ask that any, you know, programs in the DNA or any other level of their being, any contracts even, that, you know, forces them to fight with each other, we ask that to be cleared, and that in this lifetime, you know, they're going to be a great example of how male and female energies can work together in a body and how they can accomplish so much more than just, you know, Mrs. Girly woman and or he-man man, you know. A strong man with the intuition and finesse of a woman is definitely more effective than a crude he-man. Right? I will thank now all those beings that helped. And we asked that your energies be nicely intertwined now. And that there's a balance now between your male and female high self, so that everybody just steps forward and it is their strong time, you know? We all are specialized on something. And so, you know, this is bringing the talent forward and supporting it, so that not one just overrules the other. It's a back and forth, like a happy dance, you know, playful. And let's have the inner children and the inner teenagers also mixed in, so there is a lot of fun there. Amen, 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 amen. And to thank all those beings that helped to facilitate this healing new meditation. Thank you so much for your support and arrangements. Amen. So it is. And to ask that any negative energies or entities that still should be moved, that they please move, be moved now. Amen. And that any portals that should be opened or closed or guarded, please do so now. Amen. And one, you become aware of your room where you are. And two, you start sliding back into your body, reintegrate into your body. And all your subtle bodies start to integrate with each other way better than before, than ever before. And we like to ask for an updating of your DNA and an integration of all your subtle bodies, yes, and a nice calibration. And one, you become aware, you know, you open your eyes and you're back in present time. Well, thank you back. I hope you had a good experience. Again, no driving or operating heavy machinery. Drink a lot of water, I would say a quart, maybe a liter of water. You know, so to detox, if you have a headache, you probably need to drink more water. Because with the spiritual detoxification, the physical detoxification will follow. As above, so below. Right, so and this was only a shotgun meditation. And you are probably not going to solve all the problems, you know, of your life and your male and female discrepancies, you know, in one session. You know, it's, but, you know, even if you have a little success, this is definitely good and probably a lot faster than other forms of therapy in this regard. You know, this has their place. And some very, very wonderful experiences can be had. You know, also the information density of this guided meditation is very high. So, you know, to do it again is always a good thing. And so, till you get bored, you can do this again. And, you know, and there will be a time where you plateau out and then, you know, you stay away from it and do other stuff. You know, you will know when to kind of go back to it. When you start thinking about the meditation, you know, it's time to check whether it's good for you to do it or not. So, of course, you know, many issues have to be looked up in greater detail before they can release. And, you know, many times there are lessons needed for trauma to be transmuted or insight is gained. So, the insight is kind of like, you know, the homework you got to do, and then your spirit guides and God provide the fixings. So I just pray and ask, you know, for the highest, most accessible guidance. May it be through books, YouTube info, website, people, nature, and dreams, or much more, or people like me. You know, treat yourself to a private Skype sessions. And cut right to the chase. My prices are very, very reasonable. Just send me an email and I will, you know, send you the information, you know, the info you can find in the credits or in show more below. You know, especially if you respond well to this guided meditation, do the cyber stuff, you know, to increase my ratings, subscribe, ring the bell, give thumbs up, tell your friends, leave comments, smile like an idiot, and enjoy my other videos too. I love you. Namaste.